I'm Saskia Lavrijsen and I'm the project leader of the Longyear project. Because of technological innovations such as smart meters, IoT and sensors, a lot of data is available for the managers of our vital assets, like the bridges and the dikes. However, very often, the data is not used in a very efficient way to make these infrastructures perform better. Within the Longyear project, we investigate what are the main barriers for making use of data to help these infrastructure operators to improve the functioning of their vital infrastructures. We do this from the legal perspective and the organizational perspective.
We are working together, therefore, with five infrastructure managers, including Alliander, Vitens, Rijkswaterstaat, ProRail and the Port of Rotterdam. They are also partners in our research project. I'm looking at it from an operational management perspective. And we are looking at two specific things. On one hand, we're looking at how organizations and their direct partners can use data. And there we see that data is not only about collecting data, but also making sure you have the access to the right data, that you can actually transform it correctly. And on the other hand, we're looking at the whole sector as well, and how operation management view could have helped policymakers in making better decisions.
In terms of scientific impact of my research, I would say that I'm adding to legal scholarship in the area of data regulation. At the moment, most of this scholarship is focusing on how data is used by big tech companies in the private sector, and very little attention is given to other actors, like very important actors like infrastructure operators, which are also becoming data-driven.
With my research project, I hope to help infrastructure managers, but also policymakers, to ensure that data is being better used by the infrastructure managers, and that they are also being able to actually utilize digital technologies to the fullest potential. An example could be related to the recent floodings that we've seen that there are some weak spots in the dikes, and we're hoping that by helping infrastructure managers to better use data to prevent floodings or preventively make those dikes stronger.
In terms of societal impact, what has been really interesting of this project is that we've been able to share our research insights, also the ones from the legal perspective, with the project partners, and we can see how they are embracing these insights, being more aware of the importance of sound regulation and clear legal rules in their processes and in the way they go about with data. And also we've seen that they are actually using these insights from our research to adjust their data sharing policies and also contracts, for instance.
One really fun thing about the research project is that it's not only academic, so we're not looking at academic results, but we're also working very closely together with infrastructure managers in the public sector. As such, I'm not only taking data from them, I'm also actively involved with their processes, I'm working at the offices. So while doing research, I was also able to help them and to give them insights into how to organize the relationships with contractors.
The next step will be that we do not only look at how data governance and data management within the organizations can be improved, but also how these operators can cooperate together to make sure that they can share data with each other and that they can operate as a systems of systems, meaning that all relevant data can be collected in a central platform to which, for instance, new companies can have access and they can develop new services for consumers and for businesses.
I think the Longyear project is quite unique by combining the perspectives from researchers from TISEM and the law school. This is a combination that normally is not pursued, and it's been very interesting to work together and see how, for instance, legal aspects influence organizational aspects and the other way around.